First of all, I want to say thank you all for coming here today, and I want to thank also everyone that is behind me here today, including Lieutenant Governor Garamanti and Insurance Commissioner Poisner, and also the Governor, Governor Gibbons from Nevada. We really appreciate him also be here today and everyone else. Thank you very much. I want to thank also right off the top all the firefighters who have done such an extraordinary job here fighting these fires 24 hours a day. Without any doubt, they are, you know, the most extraordinary heroes. As I've said many times, I've done action movies where I played the hero, but those are the true action heroes. And I just wanted to say that we simply have the bravest and the most skilled firefighters, and we have even seen you know, write-ups and people talking about it in Europe. I just came back from Europe, and people talk about the greatest firefighters and the best trained and the toughest firefighters in the world. That's what they call the California firefighters. I mean, it's really extraordinary. So I just want to say thank you to all of them. And I know that much of the Western United States has experienced droughts, and this is why we have seen that coming, that everyone has said, the experts have said that they predicted severe fire seasons this coming year and this year, and that's why in May I issued an executive order to mobilize additional fighter personnel, fighting personnel, and firefighting equipment and all of this, so that we are prepared and that we are ready for that. And it has paid off now on this particular fire. I just got the latest update. We have 1,900 firefighters that are fighting here and fire personnel. 44% of the fire has been contained. We have here 3,100 acres that were destroyed. Anywhere between 175 to 200 homes have been destroyed, and additional 75 structures have also been destroyed. More than 3,500 residents have been evacuated, and luckily very orderly and peacefully evacuated. Miraculously, we had no fatalities and we had no serious injuries. There were some injuries amongst firefighters, and we hope that they will be healed up as soon as possible, and we hope they're back on the job again as quickly as possible. This was, of course, a very fast-moving fire and a very destructive fire. But it could have been much worse if we wouldn't have had such well-trained firefighters. I also want to take this opportunity to thank our Lieutenant Governor John Garamanti, who was the acting governor during the time I was overseas. He has done an extraordinary job. He jumped into action, briefed me continuously while I was gone, as soon as the fire started. And for him, the most important thing was, of course, to protect the people and the property and to control the fire as quickly as possible and to get the people back to the normal life, and also to rebuild this community as quickly as possible. So let's give a big hand to Lieutenant Governor John Garamanti. We also have here with us our great insurance commissioner, Steve Poisner, who is going to do a great job. He's here with his whole team to again get in touch with the people and to make sure that they get their homes and their lives back together as quickly as possible. Let's give a big hand also to Steve, right here, Steve Poisner. Thank you very much. Thank you. This was, of course, one of the worst fires that lay in Lake Tahoe's history. And we took a very quick and decisive and quick action on multi-fronts. And I think this is what really helped us here to contain this fire and to bring it somewhat under control. Beginning on Sunday afternoon, soon after the fire was reported, I was in constant contact with everybody, with the emergency officials, and with, as I said, with Lieutenant Governor Garamanti. And on Monday morning, he issued an emergency proclamation for El Dorado County that will provide state funding in order to cover the costs of fighting the fire and also to rebuild the infrastructure and the structures as quickly as possible. On Tuesday, we created the local assistance center that will help people who have been displaced by the fire. And the center offers, of course, one-stop assistances from a score of different state agencies. We are here to help all the people to make sure that the fire victims get quick assistance, because that's the important thing, is to get quick assistance, and that's what we are trying to do here. Lake Tahoe is one of the most beautiful places we all know, not only in the great state of California, but I would say all over the world. I mean, this place has been known all over the world. And so I think it is very important for us to bring this back to shape as quickly as possible. I think, like all Californians, I'm very concerned about what happens now the next few days, weeks, months, and years ahead of us. The fire is still not fully contained. I think that the firefighters know that there's a huge challenge ahead of them and a lot of work ahead of them to contain this fire. But I've already directed the California resources and the California Environmental Protection agencies to draft an aggressive restoration plan as quickly as possible to keep Tahoe restored and to bring it back to its pre-fire conditions. This will require a great deal of effort and cooperation of all the agencies, if it is the federal agencies, state agencies, regional and local agencies. I think everyone is now working together. That's a key to respond to all of this as quickly as possible. And with that, now I just want to say again, thank you very much to the firefighters and to all of you for working together here. And now I would like to have Lieutenant Governor John Garamendi come out and say a few words, please.
Governor, thank you very much. What we have seen over the last 3 days is extraordinary effort by the local citizens, by the firefighters from California, from the federal government, and also from the state of Nevada. Governor Gibbons, your people were over here immediately, both the firefighters as well as police agencies. That kind of interstate cooperation really is a hallmark of what has always taken place here in the Tahoe Basin. This is a spectacular part of this world, and men and women, local, federal, and state, saved a large part of this community. But unfortunately, there are victims of this fire, and many people have lost their homes. As we toured the fire a few moments ago, the governor noticed on the ground this. And those of us that were following behind him said it reminds us of a certain line in a movie. And we'd like to change the first word of that. Instead of I, it's "we'll be back." This community will be back, Governor. And you should keep this as a symbol of what the restoration will be here in this community. This community will pull itself together. And as a result of the efforts that have been made, it will happen. Governor, you have many, many responsibilities. Among them, you are a world leader in dealing with the climate crisis. And yes, you're out of state, and you were dealing with that problem, leading California and this nation, and indeed the world, on an incredibly important task of climate crisis. You have a very skilled, talented, and capable team here in the state of California, and they pulled together to make a successful stand against this fire. And I congratulate them, and I thank your team for making it happen.
Thank
Governor,
you. Thank you.
Thank you. Our insurance commissioner, Steve Poisner, please.
Good afternoon. First of all, let me just say that my thoughts and prayers go out to the victims here in South Lake Tahoe area. There's been over 260 homes burned to the ground. Another 20 homes have been seriously damaged. We estimate the losses in excess of $150 million now. So it's very important to remember the victims here over the last several days. I also want to show my deep appreciation for the firefighters and the law enforcement officials who were here in the trenches risking their lives to help Californians. My job as insurance commissioner is to help victims recover as quickly as possible. So I've deployed two strike forces here from my California Department of Insurance here in the South Lake Tahoe area. The first group is my disaster assessment team. Be on the ground here to assess the damage, work with homeowners and insurance companies to make sure that we cut through the red tape so homeowners get their insurance payments as quickly as possible so families can get back on their feet. My second task force is a group of people from my fraud division. It's my fraud assessment team. And my fraud officials will be working very closely with law enforcement officials here in South Lake Tahoe to make sure that they don't get victimized by scam artists. Every time there's a natural disaster in California, bad actors come to the area and try to rip off those victims again. And we're going to make sure that folks that are here are protected. We're going to be on the lookout for people who are unlicensed contractors. We're going to be on the lookout for people who are unlicensed claims adjusters, and if we find them, we're going to come down on them like a ton of bricks. So at the Department of Insurance, we're here to help victims. If anybody has a question about their insurance policy, about some potential insurance fraud, call us at 1-800-927-HELP. 1-800-927-HELP. We're here to help victims. Thank you all very much.